Hi students, welcome to my channel. My name is T. Rajshekhar, working as a lecturer in civil engineering from SRS Government College in Sisila. So today we are going to see the topic of pavement and curb markings. Objectives: on completion of this class, you will be able to explain different road markings like pavement markings and curb markings. Okay? So in the previous class we have discussed grade intersections, grade interchanges, and how is the traffic guided on roads, and how is the traffic guided at intersections, and what are different pavement markings you see on the road surface. Okay, so these are the topics we have discussed in the previous class. Now we are going to see the markings of a road. So next is traffic control devices. In order to control, regulate and guide traffic, it is necessary to have suitable traffic aids or devices which are known as traffic control devices. Okay, so now control traffic, we need the policeman and all over. We need the traffic control devices just like signaling. Okay, signaling is a major one for controlling the traffic, and CC cameras. Okay, it will also taking the photographs and giving the fines. Okay, so those are nothing but traffic control devices. And traffic control devices are of three basic types. Those are road markings, road signs, traffic signals. So road markings, certain lines, patterns, words, symbols or reflectors on the pavement, curved sides of pylons or on fixed objects near the road, they are marked on the surfaces, which are known as road markings or traffic markings. So what are the road markings? You can see patterns, words, symbols, whatever which is marked on the road, okay, road or on any islands besides and or the curbs, nothing but these are all considered as the road markings. So forms of road markings, here first one is arrow marking, bus stop marking, center line marking, guidelines, curb markings. So these are all road markings. And next, markings demarcating traffic lines, parking space limits, pedestrian crossings, stop lines. Okay, so these are all things are considered the road markings. So you can see types of road markings. In types of road markings, we are having pavement markings, curb markings. So these are the road marking. You can see a line diagram. So different types of pavement markings you can see. So this is nothing but pavement marking, and we will call as footpath. Pedestrian crossings also. So pavement and curb markings diagram. So this is an under flyover bridge. So which are marking with black paint, these are nothing but pavement and curb markings. So pavement markings, they are generally of white paint. Yellow color markings are used to indicate parking restrictions and for continuous center line. Longitudinal lines are used as guiding or regulating lines. Transverse solid lines indicate the position of stop lines for regular traffic. So here you can see in the pavement markings, they are of white paint and some are of yellow color markings. Okay. So these are all nothing but pavement markings. And long lines also will be painted with paint. Okay. And transverse solid lines also indicate the position of the stop lines for the regular traffic. So now, types of pavement markings. Remember this question: center line markings, lane line markings, no passing zone markings, turn markings, stop line markings, cross walk line markings, parking space limits, bus stops. So these are all comes under the pavement markings. The first one you can see pavement marking. So these all diagrams concerning the pavement markings. And next is curb markings. The markings on the curb and edges of pylons with alternate black and white increase the visibility from a long distance. And next, curb markings may also indicate certain restrictions like parking regulations. Okay, you can see the black and white paint or any white and yellow paint which are marked on the for a long distance will be visible. So So these curve markings also indicate the restrictions like parking regulations. So this is an example for the curve marking. It is marked with yellow and black tape. So we can see on the road, middle of the road, this one. So this portion is called curb marking. So here also we can see in this portion between the yellow and black tape, whichever, whatever is painted. So these are all curb markings. And next, footpaths. Footpaths are provided on each side of the road for the safety of pedestrians. The width should be 1.5 meters in residential areas and 3.0 meters in shopping areas. Remember this one. For footpath, 1.5 meters should be in residential and 3 meters should be in shopping areas. Footpath should be about 150 mm above the road edge. So from the ground level, that means the road, below the road, the one up to 1.150 mm, the footpath should be height, okay? Not on the same level of road. And they should be free from obstructions, okay? And they are paved with cement concrete, bricks or stone slabs with the space towards the road or island. They also should be free from cement concrete, okay? They should not be have any obstructions for the footpath. They should be free from road, okay? And they should be like cement concrete or any bricks or stone slabs, okay? And next is cycle tracks. A cycle track is a part of a roadway designed and constructed for the use of pedal bicycles. A separate cycle track is provided when peak hour cycle traffic is 400 or more. So we can see in the foreign countries or in our area also, for cycle traffic we will be having the roads, okay? Separate roads will be there besides the traffic, so the separate lane will be there. So in this way only the cycle will be traveling, okay? And types of cycle tracks are adjoining cycle tracks, daisy cycle tracks, free cycle tracks. So these are all nothing but types of cycle tracks. And traffic control devices, the 5 basic requirements for use of traffic control devices are: it must convey clear and simple meaning, it must command attention, it must command respect of road users, it must give adequate time for proper response, and it must justify its necessity. Okay? So these are nothing but 5 basic requirements for the traffic control devices. Okay? It should be convey the clear and simple meaning. And it must command the attention. So whatever the traffic control devices are there, they should regulate and follow the traffic rules, and they should control the traffic rules. Okay. And next, to ensure fulfillment of control devices, it is necessary to give proper attention to the design, placement, operation, maintenance and uniformity of all traffic control devices. So it should give compulsory design and placement, okay, and operation, or it should operate the vehicles, okay, and maintenance and uniformity, okay. So you can see now some markings are there. So these are all arrow markings. So whatever the markings are there, this is for, so this is for the left side, left road we have vehicle, and this is for the right side, and this is for the straight or left, okay. So these indicate the arrows for straight road, okay. Nothing but these are all arrow markings. And these are bus stop markings for waiting for the bus stop. You can see these lines will be provided inside the bus stop markings. And next is center line. This is the center line, and this is the hazard line, and this will call the solid white line. So these are all the center line markings. So this is also center line marking road, and down one is guideline markings. You can see here. Go slow, school zone, and this is cycle zone. Okay, stop here in the traffic. Okay, so these downwards are nothing but guideline markings, and the upper one is nothing but center line markings. Okay, summary. So we discussed today traffic control devices, road markings like pavement and curb markings, characteristics and requirements of traffic control devices. So these are all very important topics in this chapter. So today, these compulsory the road markings we have to give for the road by request to control the traffic and to move frequently on the roads and to on the footpath and pedestrian ways. Okay, so examination questions list different road markings, say the need for road markings, and long answer questions draw the sketches of only 4 road markings. Okay, so these are the important questions in this chapter unit. Okay, so Thank you. Have a nice day.